looks like it's here to stay. Well, for another week at least. It seems only too fitting that we crack into an ice cream or two. And today we are sticking stateside with Michigan's Saugatuck Brewing Co. First opening their doors back in 2005. SBC are dedicated to the entire craft experience. From creative food menus to their unique brews. And it's pretty safe to say today's brew very much falls into that category. As today we are haunted by the ghost of Neapolitan. A drinking experience like no other. The Ghost of Neapolitan has all the flavours of their iconic Neapolitan Milk Stout, which I can actually recall trying once a few years back. But this one comes with a little twist. It may drink like a stout from mouthfeel to flavour, but you'll be surprised when you open your eyes to a copper-coloured ale. You'll get a taste of rich chocolate, vanilla, and strawberry in this fascinating white stout. And from what I do remember about that original Neapolitan, it was just a touch on the sweet side. That strawberry really did overpower somewhat. But with all US imports, you never can tell just how fresh they're gonna be once they wash up on our shores. So I'm happy to chalk that one up as another that's lost in transit. So let's pull out the flakes and head on down to the beach. Let's get pouring. So it is very, very sweet. But it is, it's more raspberry than strawberry I'm getting. Of course, there is that subtle vanilla and chocolate in the background too. And I would say it's more ribenery than Neapolitan. And there are some almost subtle floral or rosy notes to it too. So there is a real sweetness up top. It's got real berry-like notes without being overly specific. And it must be said, it's not a particularly natural berry note. It is quite syrupy. There is a subtle creaminess to it, but that really is more in the body than it is in the flavour. And it does fade out with a real sugary, syrupy finish. And although it does leave a real bitterness in the mouth, it almost seems a bit of a mystery as to where that bitterness is coming from, as it does seem to just spring up out of that sugary sweetness with no real warning. So there are some malty notes, some almost wheaty notes developing in those middles now, which are bleeding into that tail and giving that bitter mouthfeel just a little bit of a purpose. But it's up top where those issues lie. It is still quite ribenery, quite cordial-like, instead of something real fresh and fruity. And quite similar to the original Neapolitan, those chocolate and vanilla notes are still very, very subtly hidden away. And now we're down into the final third-ish. I've got to admit, it hasn't been one to remember. Well, maybe it has, just for not very good reasons. And I am happy to chalk that up to a bit of bad travel, but this is the second one of theirs I've tried now that has definitely been under par. It is just overly sweet, not something I'm usually overly critical on. But in this case, that sweetness is just so artificial. And very, very syrupy, not just in flavour, but in body too. And it definitely has to be noted, it isn't particularly balanced all that well. Very similar to the previous Neapolitan, that vanilla and chocolate really are quite difficult to dig out. If it was a day out of the beach, you'd definitely need the Coast Guard to help you find where they are. And it goes from that ribena, like that cordial sweetness, into a bittery, wheaty note, with not much in between. And if truth very much be told, I'm probably going to have a hard time getting through the rest of it.